Avast, me hearties, it be I, your humble pirate captain, sailed back from port. And as your humble pirate captain, I have to say, everyone is welcome, and I am love to listen what you have to bring in the discussions if you have something to say. The reason why I'm saying this is because I've learned of a particular crazed person today that is incredibly aggressive to people that disagree with him. And he is currently a board member of Patreon and ex-CEO of Twitter. And you know what he said? He declares that every individual who separates business from activism, so those two parts are separated, if you agree with that, that you should be put against a wall and be shot at with guns. Wow! There is nothing so hate-filled like this. You might as well say, kill the Jews. That's pretty much the equivalent of that. Listen, I'm not harping against Jewish people or anything. Yo-do-yo, I don't care. But that is the equivalent. It is incredibly totalitarian and incredibly oppressing against the other side. If I would have replaced this with any of the protected classes of YouTube, that would be immediately labeled as a racist or sexist, and I would be unable to show my face anywhere. This is horrible. But what could have triggered someone saying this? Well, pretty much the exact different response. Paul Graham tweeted out that activism is well-intentioned, what I do agree with, because I think quite a bit of activists are well-intentioning people who have no idea that what they're doing is incredibly destructive. What I've learned in my many, many years of life is you need to focus on what kind of results you want instead of what is right. There's a difference in that. Let's say you have a nature preserve, and on that nature preserve you release a lot of wild horses in order to maintain it easier and alleviate your costs a bit. But what happens during the winter is a lot of the wild horses are dying because there isn't enough food. So what is the smart thing to do? Well, conventionally what you'll jump upon is feeding the horses, of course, because they don't have enough food. But that is the dumbest idea to do. It is incredibly wrong. What you should do is kill the horses. That's what you should do. It sounds counterintuitive, but there's a reason why. Because if you feed the horses, then you'll get more horses. Because there more horses survive through the winter, and because of that, you get more calves of the horses, and those calves need to eat. And what happens during the summer is because you have more horses who survived, you lose more plants. And those plants are incredibly important to the ecosystem, even more than the horses. Because those plants determine what kind of animals are able to propagate there, not only the horses. You want to have a diversity of different animals, and if you focus on one animal, then you ignore all the entire chain of food. That's why shooting the horses, predation, is better than feeding them. For an example, and what Paul Graham is saying here is pretty much something similar. That activism as a company might be well intentioned, but usually a cheap gimmick to show, yay, we are progressive, give us money to show how progressive we are. That's usually the case. It only distracts the company from more important matters, like quality and other things. For example, the infamous Gillette commercial. Even though it might be well-intentioned, might as well be a stab to men, it was incredibly misinformed and turned a lot of people off Procter and Gamble products and Gillette products in general, giving them an incredible downturn. And the person who is angry at this is Dick Costolo. And he is angry because he thinks that distracting your employees with activism, what Paul Graham said, is the same as telling them to shut up and dribble. And I disagree with him. He did not say that anywhere close. He said it isn't useful, activism. And he never told, and he even claimed that it might be well-intentioned, claiming that he can see where people are going wrong or right. So he is open for this kind of stuff, and you aren't, Dick Costolo. And you have the hypocrisy to say that tech companies used to be welcome lively debate about ideas and society. Too bad about the ideas that disagree with you and the people that you think should be shut up. Or shut up. Anyways, I'm going to leave it at there. This incredibly hot take is made by an incredible communist who think capitalism is something heretical, even though he is a CEO of Patreon and ex-CEO of Twitter. Capitalism helped you incredibly, Dick Costolo, and if anyone that should be shut up, not saying that if you're going to threaten him, I do not want you to threaten him, it will only give him fuel, so do not do that. But if anyone should be shut up, it's you, because your attack like this is incredibly totalitarian and dangerous. Anyways, I'd be Pirate Captain Toast, this here be me rant for today, and I wish you guys the best of luck. Subscribe to my channel to join me crew, follow me on BitChute, Twitter, and Discord, and I wish the good tidings, and may you always have a good breeze of wind in ye sails.